Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm your girl RS Lewis, aka the Insomniac Writer. Today I have another trailer reaction. I am looking at Dear Santa. Okay, so Jack Black got another film coming out. Wait a minute, wasn't he gonna be in the Minecraft? What happened with Minecraft?
The whole thing is just awkward.
That's still coming out. I don't know. I reacted to the trailer, but Lord knows I have no clue of what's going on with it. But anyway, I love me some Jack Black. So it is what it is. I'm going to go check this out, and we're going to talk about it for just a little bit. So strap in, get your chips, dips, and all that other good stuff. I got water because I got to stay hydrated in these streets. And without further ado, let's get to it.
Every Christmas, something magical happens.
Dear Santa.
When a kid sends a letter to Santa. But Liam.
To Santa.
Is a crappy speller.
This looks like fun.
Oh, that's putrid.
Thank you.
What do you want?
You summoned me.
You're not what I expected.
What'd you expect?
In the movies, the reindeer usually have the antlers, not you.
Kid, are you high?
I'm ready for this.
You lucked out big time, so I'm way better than Santa.
Ho, ho, frickin' ho.
You, my friend, are getting 3 wishes.
You mean like a genie?
They stole that from me. By the way, after you make your wishes, I'm taking your soul.
What?
You ain't never had a friend like me. Okay, that I may have stolen from Aladdin. Now we're even.
Let me show you a few of the things I could do for you.
I'll be right back!
It's Post Malone!
Leo!
Look, I'm worried Santa's going to trick me into getting my soul.
I think he's just confused.
We believe you.
It's nuts. No.
Down here! What are you waiting for? Go make a move! Sue me, I'm thirsty!
I tried everything. That kid's incorruptible.
What about doing something out of kindness?
I don't even know what you just said. I mean, I know all the words, but I just never heard them in that order.
You know this man?
I'm his uncle, beat it.
Who do you think you are talking to me like that?
Ooh. That doesn't sound right.
Pardon me, kombucha.
Watch this.
Lock. No, please. Never trust a fart. You just gambled and lost.
Nice to meet you. The pleasure was mine.
Okay, so that was Dear Santa with Jack Black. I love Jack Black, man. He is hilarious, especially when he is allowed to be as animated as he wants to be. And I think this is the perfect role for that. One of my fave, I don't know if it's like, I would say it's my top 5 Jack Black movies, School of Rock. And this is just perfect for him. The last Kung Fu Panda. I didn't see. I took my daughter to see the other ones, but the last one I didn't see. But when he did that Hit Me Baby One More Time, I must have watched that on Instagram like 30 times. Like, yes. He's just so animated. He just seems like he's just so much fun to be around. So anyway. Yo, this youngin can't fucking spell.
You're a dumbass.
He put Satan instead of Santa. Yo, let me tell you something. Look, one letter mess you up. It's like, wait a minute. It's not S-A-N-T-A. He put S-A-T-A-N. Lord help him. Bless his little heart. So anyway, this looks like it's going to be a very fun holiday film. For Christmas time is coming up. I love, like, I don't care if you celebrate Christmas or not. The Christmas movies I love funny ones like this, like The Elf, Scrooge, you know, so many, like the you know, Miracle on 34th Street, stuff like that to make you all emotional. I don't want to watch that.
You need to leave.
I want to watch funny stuff. I want to, you know, have the feel goods. Rather, I'm celebrating, well, we celebrate Hanukkah, and Hanukkah is going to be coinciding with Christmas this year. So therefore, the gift-giving season, no matter how you choose to celebrate it or what faith you are subscribed to, or even if you ain't subscribed to any damn thing, you just want to get some presents. Hey, I think this is going to be a good film. Let's jump into this cast real quick. We got Jack Black as Satan, a.k.a. Santa Claus.
Damn it!
On paper, this sounds like a good idea, but when you have sat in a few theological classes, you realize just how wrong this is. And it, and then you talk about the genie and the.
I'm not doing this with you.
Moving along, we have Keegan-Michael Key. He is, I don't know, he's a therapist and he's hilarious too. So it looks like this whole entire class of people is just funny. And he's hilarious. I mean, Key and Peele, aloo. So he, I love when he does, I forget, what's the teacher that is going to come to me always mispronouncing somebody's name? He just be messing up people's names. Oh my God. Moving along, Post Malone is going to be himself. I've been seeing this man been doing some acting. He was in that reboot of Roadhouse and he had a short stint in that. He's done other stuff. I've listened to a few of his songs. I don't know where to classify him. Like, I used to keep my, you know, CDs back in the day, my cassettes.
Oh, damn.
They would be alphabetized by genre. And then I learned to stop doing that at some point. Limp Bizkit was the reason why I stopped doing that. Shut up, I'm old. He's one of those other people too, because you don't know what he does. Is it hip hop, pop, rap, trap? He's doing some country. It's kind of like what Kid Rock was doing for a second there. He was doing some rap country. Who's another one? The call me by your name. Lil Nas. Is hip hop ish. It's hip hop ish. It's a subgenre of hip hop. Anyway, the point is, look, do your thing. He's like, look, I want to act. I want to sing. I want to rap. I want to dance. I want to do it all. And you know what? I ain't even mad at you, bro. Do your mother effing thing. Moving along. We have, oh God, Hayes MacArthur. I don't know who he is, but he does look very familiar. Let's look back on IMDb.
Not today.
Super Troopers. Oh, part two. I didn't see that one. But he's obviously a comedian. He looks very familiar. She's Out of My League. I remember that too. For some reason, I don't know why. They had the dude from This Is the End. Moving on, we got Brienne Howie. And she's such a cute little actress. I don't remember her in a lot of things. She was in The Passage that had the little girl and Zach from Saved by the Bell, who's now on that show Found, which is damn good. And she was also in the Exorcist series, if I'm not mistaken. But she's a good up-and-coming actress. She's done a lot, mostly in TV shows and stuff like that. But I'm looking forward to seeing her in a movie. We have, little cute Jaden Carson Baker. He's going to be playing Gibby. Maybe he's a friend of the other kid, who I forgot to mention right after Jack Black. Liam Turner, that little kid that can't spell shit, is will be played by Robert Timothy Smith. And this little kid is adorable too. I love when the kid actors are really, really good, but they play a little bit of a little seriousness, because I've heard kid actors are hard to deal with. I don't know, but in the past, a lot of people say, I don't want to root with kids, but they end up being cool. And it seems like it's a lot of kids in this. We're rounding off this cast. We have PJ Byrne. This guy is funny. He's been, he's always that guy that's just in the bad situation or in the wrong place at the wrong time. It don't matter. Remember, he was in The Boys, Wolf of Wall Street, and he was in that Final Destination one. The one he was in the massage parlor. And he, with the Buddha statue and the pins, that was, I think that was his death scene. But in The Premonition, he was on the bus because he was in the back. He had to go to the bathroom, come out the bathroom. That bus is crashing head first into the river. So, hey, it is what it is. This looks very good. I think it's going to be fun. It's going to be airing on Paramount Plus. So If you have the Paramount Plus streaming app, and probably most of us do, streaming apps are the new cable, basically. Looks like it's going to debut on November 25th, 2024. So it looks like it's going to be on other digital platforms too. So even if you don't have Paramount Plus, I don't know if it's going to be exclusive to this, but since now a lot of these things are umbrellaed and partnering with other streaming platforms like the OG ones, Netflix, you need to do this. But Amazon Prime and Hulu, for example, you can add on different streaming services to them. You know, they might not be partnered with them per se. You might pay extra. Like Hulu and Disney kind of come together because they're under the same ownership, but I don't know how it works out. But anyway, the point is, this is going to be on Paramount. So, what did you think of Dear Santa, the trailer? Did you like it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Are you going to go watch it? Leave your comments down below, because where else are you going to leave them? And before you go, make sure you like, subscribe, and hit that bell so you can be notified of other videos and stuff. And that's about it. Obviously, I got to charge my equipment. I am having some technical difficulties, and this is going to be fun editing. Whew, man, listen, let me tell y'all something. I'm not like one of the big YouTubers, obviously, like Dead Meat James or Zavid or other people that are like, I watch. But I understand, like when people say, why you ain't posting, da, 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 you used to post so much. I love the fact that I can put content out there and talk about the things that I love in movies and stuff like that. But it's not the fun that it was in the beginning. Like, I'm having a ball doing this. See, my page is not monetized. So when they come with the copyright, well, as long as it's not strike, if they come with the claims, as long as the video is airing and it's not affecting viewership, that's fine. But for someone like James or Xavier, whoever, who this is their stream income, and they give them this bullshit, like, oh yeah, the copyright, you can't say this, you can't say, like, you can't drop but so many F-bombs. You really feel like you have to hamper down all the, you know, who you are and the content that drew the people to you in the first place. So I understand, like, IG is not the way it used to be. I was popping on IG for a second, and now I'm like, wait a minute, you mean to tell me out of 20 something thousand people, no one or one person saw this post? So it's like, we got to fight with an algorithm, we got to fight with copyrights and strikes and censorship and shadow banning and everything friggin' thing else. So yeah, anyway guys, I'm about to get out of here. Take care, be awesome, be you, but above all else, love yourself. And I'm out. I'm not even tired, I just got a lot of stuff to do and I need to get out of here. I need to not be rambling on these videos. So yeah, that's that.